I encourage you, if you are interested in this topic, to go out to my website. And in addition to this movie that you saw here, I've got movies that show a part of the Canadian healthcare system that you had no inkling of if you've seen SICKO or any portion of it. The Canadian system rations healthcare, and I show some cases that I think will shock you, one of which is a movie on my website called Two Women that chronicles the sad story of Janice Fraser of Ontario. Now, Ms. Fraser was about 39 years old when her bladder ceased to function. She needed a pacemaker-type device implanted to stimulate urination, and that was going to be that. Here in the United States, if you're in Washington, D.C., you can find someone to do this operation. Just go out on the web. Go to Medtronic's website, plug in your zip code. You will find a specialist here, probably within blocks of here, that can do that operation. You would get that operation, a matter of weeks probably. Not being able to urinate is actually a pretty urgent situation, having to wear a catheter. In Ontario, at the hospital where she was going to have her operation, the only hospital where she could have the operation, she was told, they rationed this procedure to one a month. There were 32 people on that list to receive that operation, of which she was number 32. So, you know, do the math. It's nearly a three-year wait, wearing a catheter, waiting for this operation. She tried to wait. She did everything she could to get the attention of the health minister, who would not speak with her or even return her letters. And at the end of the day, she developed severe infections in her bladder that caused an emergency where they had to remove the bladder. And she wears a urine bag now at the age of 40 for the rest of her life. And you'll see that in my film. That is hardcore rationing. And that you will not find in the United States. I've got another movie out there called The Lemon, in which I contrast, I compare single-payer systems like Canada's to the Trabant. If you remember the Trabant, the East German automobile that was sort of a single-payer auto industry in Germany. And I chronicle the story of a woman whose mesenteric artery, which is the large artery that feeds the bowels, brings blood to the bowels, enables you to digest food, was nearly completely blocked. This is something that happens a lot to smokers, heavy smokers. And she was scheduled for surgery, then her surgery was canceled. This was a dire situation. She was literally starving to death. And in this movie, you'll see the interview that I have with the Canadian doctor, and he says straight up, the last patient I had with this waited and waited, and he waited until he was so weak that when he had the surgery, he died soon after. He'd essentially starved to death. So here we have people starving to death, waiting for mesenteric, the condition is a mesenteric ischemia. We have people starving to death in Canada while waiting for this surgery. A lot of people will say, well, these are just anecdotes. And I will admit, I am partisan and one-sided in the debate. I'm presenting the other side, I think the side that you don't hear as much, or at least you're not going to hear as much in these days. But I will say that I've taken no liberties with the truth. The stories that I show here, I'm not omitting anything important that you should know, and I'm showing merely the facts of what healthcare rationing looks like in Canada. Now, I saw the film last night, and I'm sure that a number of you may have seen it already at the premiere or will see it. And I have to admit that Michael Moore is very funny and very effective, and he actually says some very true things about the American healthcare system. I would probably say that about 5% of his movie is true. When he shows how HMOs callously managed care and deny payment to Americans, I mean, some of those stories are heartrending. And anyone who sees it, who's not affected by it, wouldn't be human. And so I agree with that. And these stories, there's nothing wrong with them being told. However, when you tell those stories in the way that he tells them, without telling the other side of the story, you get a distorted view. And the perfect example of that is, you know, in HMOs, they deny payment, but at least you know where you stand right off the bat. Canada is like a giant HMO, so if you've been turned down by an HMO, you know what it's like to live in Canada. The difference is that in Canada, the premiums that you pay to your so-called HMO are your taxes, and it's you're forced to pay these taxes, and there's no competition. If your HMO, if you read the newspaper that your HMO is denying care, it's not like you can go out and get another policy. Private insurance is outlawed in Canada, and you'll see these cases in my movies where people have to go to the United States to get care. Now, in the case of the woman who lost her bladder that I chronicle in my story, two women, they didn't have the money to come to the U.S., and they waited. They were going to try to mortgage their house and get the money, and they asked, can we pay for the operation? And they were told, no, you can't pay for your health care in Canada. And I really think that a lot of Americans, once they understand that that is what's being pushed by Mr. Moore and some of the more vocal advocates, especially out in California, for single payer, once Americans realize that this is what is being pushed, I think that they're not going to agree with that.
Thank you for watching Cato Weekly Video. The Cato Institute is a nonprofit organization. For more information or to find out how to give to Cato, please visit www.cato.org.